In order to have a successful and fully functioning data governance council or committee, you need to put together a terms of reference document. And here are four things it should contain. What is a terms of reference document, or a TOR? No, not a TOR, but TOR. You can check out this video for a short explanation. So first, it should outline the purpose, the role, and authority of this committee, of this council. Most often, it is responsible for the strategic guidance of the data governance program. Yes, I have another video about the data governance committee, so please watch it after this one, if you haven't seen it already, as it covers this part in more detail. Second, you should outline the criteria for how members have been, are, and will be selected. Especially if the program is enterprise-wide, covering a large organization, there can be a lot of senior leaders at different levels and plenty subject matter experts, which might feel they should be included. So you want to make the selection criteria process transparent and fair. I talk more about this in the who to include in a data governance council video. And there you have it, that's your second video to add to the list. Third, the document should contain expectations around consensus and voting. A quorum should consist of 50% of voting members plus one and should be required for all material decisions affecting project proposals and business cases. Which ones are the voting members? Well, all regular members besides the chair, but though that's your choice. You can have the chair to be one of the regular members and have voting powers, that's your choice, but just make sure you're stating that. So each member will be entitled to one vote, each voting member that is, because you might also have adjunct members or guests, which are there just for informational purposes or to provide extra value for a specific topic, answer questions, present a specific domain. So voting members. Now, if consensus cannot be achieved, the decision will be deferred to next meeting. If other regular members did not vote, or it will be referred to the data governance program sponsor. The voting procedure will be conducted by the chair. An absent member may send an opinion or notes pertaining to an agenda item for the council's deliberation through a representative. That can be allowed. But it's details like this that will help clarify the process and set the expectations to the members of this data governance council or committee. Lastly, outline the meeting expectations as well. Outline the frequency of the meetings, which should be at least monthly on a specific day of the week and time. This will allow your members to commit this time in advance. Additional meetings may be called where there is extra demand for a review of projects, policies, or strategies due to new priorities. There are plenty of things to discuss in these meetings, so don't be afraid of increasing their frequency, at least in the first year of the data governance program. You might also choose to have a clause which allows proxies to take a member's place should they not be able to make the meetings. In certain councils or committees, they only allow attendance in person and not via telephone or video conference. Whatever your decision is, just state these rules in your document. A meeting agenda should also be circulated at least 2 business days prior to the meeting, but ideally at least a week in advance. Most organizations require for any documents pertaining to the meeting to be read before the meeting, whereas others such as Amazon reserve the first part of the meeting for its members to go through the reading materials together. The choice is yours, just set the expectations in this terms of reference document. If you find some of this to be confusing or overwhelming, I put together a template of this document so you can just go ahead and download it and update it to your own needs. Simple as that. I'll make sure to put a link to it. Thank you to the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, a business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. You can use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Don't forget to check out LightsOnData.com. Here you can find more informative content such as templates, guides, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. Please don't forget to subscribe, as it's free, and it will really help me out a lot as well. Thank you.